So here with Samer Bagaeen for this episode of The Vote. Welcome back. It's been a long time, hasn't it, Samer?
It has been, Mark. Yeah. Pleasure to be back.
Yeah, and I know things have changed for you at the council because we've had a bit of a rejig of the committee system following the two by-elections. So what's the new gig that you've got on the committee? I know it's ETS, isn't it, and climate change is on the agenda.
Yeah, so I've kept my... we've got a cross-party climate member working group, so I'm still on that. Health and Wellbeing Board, still on that. But yeah, the new gig is Environment, Transport and Sustainability, which should be quite interesting with everything else that's going on around us.
So what does that include then? Because I know it includes climate change. I mean, just briefly, just because it's quite a big committee, isn't it? It's one of the bigger ones.
Yeah, it covers... The portfolio itself is quite broad in a sense,
yeah.
But it's anything that's environment related, anything that's transport related. So it could be everything from, say, the big decisions around cycle lanes to some of the smaller decisions like what happens in some of our smaller roads and so on. So it's quite a broad beef. And then a lot of the climate initiatives will go through that committee.
Right, OK. And what's on the agenda at the moment then, in terms of like the climate change issues? Because this is a big initiative, isn't it, at the moment for the council? We've got this this target for 2030, haven't we, I think. Is it net carbon zero by 2030?
Yeah, we've got the net zero. We've got this net zero initiative, yeah. which the council tweeted about a few days ago, didn't they? They've neglected to tell the rest of us that they were going to do that, by the way, but there you go. But that's come through a lot of the work that we've been doing on the net zero working group. There are things in there. I mean, it's quite a varied brief, if you like. There's some work around water. There's some work around energy. A lot of the work around hydrogen, which is happening across Sussex. So it's not only a Brighton and Hove piece of work. It's the... So we launched Hydrogen Sussex as part of this energy portfolio back in February. Had Maria Caulfield, our MP in Lewis.
Yeah.
She effectively, you know, spoke at that about how that links to some of the broader Southeast ambitions, I think, about local energy generation. So like I said, the scale of this is much bigger than Brighton and Hove, but it's good to see the city actually part of that conversation.